Ladies and gentlemen, we are back here. We're going to be going live very, very quickly. Knife Run been done with Redefine Gaming, winning the Knife Run against Anonymous. And they are off to the start on the CT side here of Cobblestone, which is the map pick coming out from Anonymous, I think. They opted to go with Cobblestone instead of Cash, which is an interesting choice. And let's see what they're going to do here. Take a look at the lineups. We do have Code. We've got Foss Fiends. Skulp. Killer Itachi for Redefine, and for Anonymous we got Magician, Spider, Ameya, Hoax, and Troll. And we are live here. So, pistol round, going live, Redefine Gaming, opting to stop on the CD side here on Cobblestone, which is a curious decision. I've noticed one thing about all the games I've casted so far recently in Premier, for the India Premiership League. I think I just broke my phone. Hold on a sec. No, it's not broken yet. So, as I was saying, most of these teams, they tend to start on the CT side, irrespective of what sort of map it is. Like, everyone chooses CT side, even on a map like Cobblestone, which you know, quite heavily prefers favors the T side, which I find kind of curious, you know. Like, if you win the knife round, you know, pick a side where you feel the map favors you the more. And I'm not very sure about what Redefine would go on the CT side. Unless, of course, I have something completely crazy planned here. Aggression coming out from Sculp. They do have Foss Fiends with the Molotov and a Flashbang, while Itachi has a kit in hand as well. For the T's, though, no utility whatsoever. 5 Glocks, 5 armors, and they are taking a little slow. Waiting for any aggression from the CTs. Two guys marking over near mid for any aggression from the CTs. But they just have Sculp over in the A bomb side, who peeked in through A long, but is going to fall all the way back to the back of the site. While they have two guys marking near the drop zone and two guys over here near B plateau, waiting for a push. We do have the C4 slowly falling back over to the over to mid near the underpass area, where Anonymous looks like they're going to be going for an A play here. Still a minute on the clock, a lot of time to work with still for the T's. And the problem is they don't have any smokes, any utility. So the problem is going to be, how will they be able to block off that double door to go for the cross? Sculp going to get the first kill on the Hoax. And Sculp knows where they're coming in here. Troll with a nice shot on the Code. And Sculp holding an angle here, tapping with the USP. Is he going to get one more? No, he won't. Troll is going to take him down. Leaving it now to the man advantage for the T's, who do have a kit on Itachi for Redefined Gaming, as Foss Fiend is taking a duel here. The Molotov not able to toss it out, though, as Killer is going to win the duel with Spider. Magician with a very quick trade coming in, leaving now the 2v2, as Foss Fiend is going to take on Magician. Killer is going to fall to Ameya, and it's going to leave it all down to Foss Fiend. He picked up the kit, though. He's going for the kill here. Oh, missing. What a number of shots on Ameya. And it's all on a Troll to hold fort. He's got 12 points of health. Foss Fiend has picked up the kit, but Troll one bullet from that P2000, and Troll is just gonna peek out and rip Foss Fiend's head off. 12 points of health, but that's okay. And he is gonna clutch it out for his team there. Anonymous, no utility whatsoever, just going in dry in A bomb side, and they're gonna win that. And Troll with a very, very crucial triple kill, gets the first two kills, and then follows it up with the ever so crucial clutch kill in the end there. 3 MAC-10s, 2 MP7s, all light SMGs, no UMPs in the picture for the T's, no rifles either, which is kind of curious. Redefine Gaming, they do have the scout on Sculp, while Killer, the only man with Kevlar and helmet with the 5.7, the rest of them just with Kevlar and 5.7s, and that could be very, very, very tough indeed against the MAC-10 and the MP7s. No head armor is going to hurt them. And Sculp is doing a massive amount of work, mind you. He's taking down two men to below 30 points of health with that scout of his. Meantime, though, Code will be taken down by Spider. So the T's are taking a lot of damage, but Spider is going to win it. Oh, wins the duel. Itachi is doing a lot of damage here. If he gets this guy close by, it could be massive. Foss Fiend's going to take control. It's going to leave it down to 3v3, but look at the health on the remaining members of the T's. Magician's the only guy with any health to speak of. And Spider takes on Sculp. To the edge of the door there, nice headshot. He's going to go for more. Takes on Itachi. It's all on Foss Fiend. He's got a MAC-10, but this could be brutal unless he gets taken down early here. And it's going to be Spider running and gunning. Picks up the ace as well. So that's a lot of money. $6,450 in the third round here. So that's a great start for them. And they will be sticking with their MAC-10s and their SMGs, knowing that Redefine will be going for a full eco round here. That's $3,000 of kill bonus just with SMG kills. That's ridiculous. Code, full eco, just USPs and few thousands. They have absolutely nothing to play with. They're aggressing here and troll. Easy pickings for him. He's going to find one. Gets a second kill as well, but it's down to 8 points of health. And very smartly, he's just going to swap his rifle with Ameya and going to pick up the MAG 10. Don't want to give away a free AK 47. Magician's going to take down Killer. He's going to leave it all down to for Sphene. Oh, they do have a couple of Peter 50s. And it's going to be the last one left alive now. He's picked up the smoke. Smoke off the doors, but in a 1v4. He could get lucky and take down Magician and Troll, but. And that's all he's going to be able to get. They have a T pushing in over from underpass. And Magician is gonna take him down. And there you have it, 3-0. And our dear producer, Anand, aka Patrick, were messaging me asking, where the hell did it put a staircase onto the B platform? It's been there, I think, a couple of updates back. You absolute noob. But yeah, that's one of the only changes they made to Cobblestone to make it a little bit more, to favor the CD side a little bit more, you know, have a couple more extra positions to hold the B side. Because the B side has been something which the terrorists have been exploiting a lot. In almost every game I've seen, at least in the top tier games, you'll see almost every team win on the T side. They always make a play for the B bomb side. Very rarely did it come to the A bomb side once in a while, but the majority of times, 70% of the times, it's 70, 80%, like, you know, and just throwing out numbers there. But yeah, majority of the times, they do make to go for this B play, which can be very tricky for the CTs to hold. So adding the staircase gives the CTs one extra position to play with. And also removes the need to go for a boost every time they want to play from the back of the platform. So, pretty interesting change from Valve. Killer is going to spot the first man. It's going to be a B push coming out from Anonymous here. Itachi is going to get the first kill. Magician is going to get taken down. They have a guy right behind the box. And Force Fiend spots a troll at the edge of the smoke. And troll might be a little confused how he died there. Nade comes in. Killer's going to take some damage, however. But CSGO nades. Does dangerous as a toothpick most of the times. And the T's realizing that a B bomb site is not something they can enter and is gonna opt to come in from underpass where they haven't checked the corner yet. And Ameya, oh! Scope little too early there. Could have made him pass by. I don't think Ameya was checking the corner as it's gonna be all down the spider in a 1v2 with 10 seconds on the clock. The bomb is dropped in A bomb side, and he's trying to save his gun, but I don't think he knows there's a CT waiting for him over to B bomb side. It's going to be Killer who takes him down. It's going to be Team Ace coming out from Redefine Gaming. One kill on each member. They did lose three rifles, however, but I'm assuming that they should be still able to go for a pretty decent buy. FAMASes coming out, perhaps. Yeah, a couple of FAMASes. Three rifles still. And decent amount of utility, three Molotovs, yeah, one Molotov picked up on the T side, picked up from the T's, we have a couple of incendiaries, a number of smokes as well, and Skull playing aggressive again over at mid, the mid underpass doors. I think he hears them, I think he hears a few of the T's making their way over from A long, but the problem is he's all alone, he does have his teammate coming in from the doors with a nice flashbang. He's going to go for more. Izzy almost gets a second kill, but he's going to get taken down. Actually, no, he just did 45 damage of hoax and not able to trade with his teammate because it was kind of far away. And I don't know what Skulp had to go for that duel. He got the first kill. He could just fallen back instead, opting to go for more. A little too hungry. That's going to make it a 1-for-1 trade, leaving it to a 4v4. And the problem is, in a 4v4 scenario, on a map like Cobblestone, where the rotations can take forever. I know, the map has been changed a lot since the old days, since the 1.6 days or from the first iteration of this map. But it still takes a while for the rotation to come in. And that's going to split the defenses. So, whenever it's a 4v4 or 3v3, it always favors the terrorists, especially on a map like Cobblestone. I think the only map where it works for the CTs is a nuke, where the rotations can be almost immediate. But that's the old nuke. The new nuke is still something I haven't personally figured out, and I don't think any team's figured out that map yet either. Although we did see, I think it was the G2 who took down team yesterday. Now it's going to be an A play coming out from Anonymous and Itachi and Code. They get a couple of kills apiece. They get a kill apiece. And Hoax is going to take on Code. Meanwhile, Itachi looking for more. He's going to find one more man living. All on a spider who's playing alone. He's going to announce himself right underneath the balcony. But Force Fiend's not going to have any trouble taking him down. And that's a good run for Redefine Gaming. They lost a couple of guns. But they will be able to swap out that the couple of FAMASes they had for an AK and the AWP. Sculp going for a smart SMG buy. The MAC-10 coming out because he does know that the Anonymous will be forced to go for an eco here. And that gun could be quite quite horrendous indeed for the T's. So 3-2, still in favor of Anonymous, as we will be seeing pretty much a full eco round. Just two or three upgraded pistols. Oh, killer, this could be dangerous. He's gonna get one, but he's gonna get swamped over, taken down by Ameya. But Itachi's holding the angle here, doing a ton of damage. He's gonna find one before it finally falls, but Code is there to pick up the slack, and he's gonna wrap the rest. You're gonna take down the rest of the T's here. Will he be able to pick up the AWP in time? No, he won't, and that's the AWP taken out of the equation. And that's a misplay. That's a misplay coming out from Killer. When you know that your opponents are on an eco, you don't have to play kind of that up close with the AWP, because there'll be four or five guys pushing out into you, and you might get one, might get two, but you'll get taken down. That's giving an AWP to the T's who had no weapons, and with that AWP in the right hand, it could pretty much, you know, make or break the round. So that was kind of sloppy play coming out from Killer to play that angle, to play that position with AWP. Now, we do have rifles, AK-47s out on Anonymous, and Sculp, once again, alone in the A-bombs that he does. His Force Fiend's coming in, and Code has been boosted up, but he should be careful here. He's making a lot of noise, and he's gonna get the kill, however, taking a ton of damage, down to 12 points of health. Meanwhile, Hoax gonna take down Sculp, and that's the A-bomb side at risk of being overrun by the terrorists, because now they still have a man there, that's Force Fiends, playing near planks, the wooden planks there, and his teammate to back him up, that's Code. He's very low in health indeed, as the T's are setting up for the smokes to go for this A play. They have a C4 slowly making its way to underpass, and it looks like it's going to be all four members coming in from underpass, no one over from long. As Force Fiends is expecting at least one T to come in. He should hear them right now. He should be moving out right now. And he gets taken down. That's kind of sloppy from Force Fiends. He heard them. There's Killer Itachi. However, I'm going to pick up the slack. I'm going to get a couple of quick kills. He's leaving down Killer Itachi again as Code is going to get taken down. He's very low. Bear in mind the nade. Ooh. In the wrong position. Hoax with a great shot on the killer. He's going to leave down Itachi to clutch this round. He knows what one of the T's are. Over in planks, flashbang coming in. Itachi making his way over to the truck. Does he know he spots the man out? And this is gonna be very tricky for him. He's gonna get the one kill magician. Now he knows where Hoax is, and he's got a Molotov. He could use this. He could really use his Molotov here. Just toss it in. Oh, runs out of bullets. This is such tough luck. And Hoax just holding the angle, takes on Itachi, and really. I get what he's trying to do, but preferably could have tossed a Molotov right behind the panels and pushed out Hoax instead. He just put it at the back entrance. So Hoax, all he had to do was just wait in that right behind the planks and wait for Itachi, to come in. It's going to be an eco run coming out from the CTs once more, but I'm not sure about it. Itachi going for the... He's invested a lot this round. It's at $900. He's gone for the 5.7 and the armor. And Killer with the FAMAS. So maybe, I think, I'm not sure. I wasn't really keeping track of the money, but maybe I think Itachi just gave him the drop or something. But the fact is, because of that, the money is kind of not equal for the CTs when they will buy up later, because Itachi's down to just about $1,000 at the moment, while the rest of them do have about $3,000. Meanwhile, there's going to be pretty much almost a B stack here, and Itachi's going to get a kill onto Magician, and this is not looking that good for the T's. Now a 4v3, there's still a guy inside the site. There's a guy over near the triangular tree. That's what I called it. His killer's going to find Ameya, leaving down to Hoax and Troll to do something. Hoax going to get another kill, leaving down to Code and Killer. And Code gonna get taken down, all on the killer right now. He's got a smoke, he's got a flash, he's got a FAMAS and a rifle as well, but Troll is gonna shut him down. Gets a double kill, him and Hoax as well. And, well, that was a little scary round for Anonymous. But Redefine Gaming should be able to go for the buy here. Except for Itachi, might just be able to afford a FAMAS. So will Sculp. Yep, there we go. FAMAS coming out on Sculp with the FAMAS as well. So, utility's not that great. They don't have any Molotovs. Not a single Molotov on the CTs. But that's okay. Code going to push into underpass. Catches our troll. There's an early pick for the CTs. Early man advantage. There's Anonymous. I want to slow things down a tad little bit. And Killer. Spraying through the smoke, hoping to get lucky. But, not able to get much luck. Magician just playing behind a smoke. A Spider's gonna find Itachi for Fiends, though, but almost immediate trade onto Spider, leaving it with the man advantage. Still with the CTs, the remaining of the Ts, though, this could be huge. This could be huge. Code, he's just gonna fall back. The timing working out for him. He could have actually been spotted by Amaya there. And he's just gonna fall back. And all he has to do is just stick around this area, convey the information. If he spots the T's coming in, that's going to draw the rotation. His teammates are still near the B-bomb side. Code holding a very tight angle is going to get the first kill. Yes, he will onto Hoax. They're going in for the refrag. He's going to get taken down. Magician with a quick trade coming in. Now 3 versus 2 and Sculp going for a wild spray. He's not going to be able to get it. He's going to make his way to the truck here. Still looking for more. He's going to get taken down by Amaya, but not before he's done a ton of damage. Amaya gets taken down by Force Fiends with a wild spray through the smoke. It's all to the Magician right now. He's got the AK. He's got a smoke as well, and bomb is going to get planted. Going to smoke off that angle. Slowly creeping around here. Gets a kill on the Force Fiends. A 1v1 right now. And Killer, he's got no kit. He's got nothing. He slowly creeps, made his way into the bomb site. Magician should be careful, but Killer, a smart play in the end there. Gets a frag. That's going to be the fourth round on board of Redefine. We do have a disconnect coming in for Redefine Gaming. So a pause should be coming in as Itachi should be reconnecting in the next couple of minutes. But 4-5, pretty close rounds. Pretty close rounds. And the fact is, even though, you know, whichever rounds Redefine are winning or whichever rounds Anonymous are winning, they're just winning it by the seat of the pants and barely a couple of guys staying alive in the end. So, interesting. I was still waiting for these guys to reconnect. I'm just going to take a look at what matchups we have for today real quickly. So we got Redefine Anonymous right now, and later, let me take a look here real quickly. I think let's see here. Yeah, so the next game is going to be Negative Evolution facing off against Team JHS. I've seen Negative Evolution in the past before, but JHS kind of an unknown quantity for me. Haven't really seen them play ever. Ever. And for Redefine Gaming, just taking a look at what they're buying up here. So we have P90 coming out in code. They should have a pretty good read that Anonymous will be going on you know, a very iffy buy or pretty much an eco. So a smart read coming out from them. And that's because they just reset the money for Anonymous. They won a couple of rounds for Anonymous, and then they lost the previous round, which Redefine managed to clutch out in a 1v1 in the end there. And that's going to kind of screw their money up. So they have an average of about $2,500 on four of the members. Troll is the only guy with any money to speak of at $4,200. So they're going to be going for an eco. So a smart pick for the P90 buy. I mean, I feel he could have gone for a less expensive SMG, which gives more, which rewards more money instead of P90. But that gun could pretty much wreak havoc amongst Anonymous. So we're still waiting on Itachi to join back. No word yet from the admin as to what happened. Hopefully, it's pardon go. That'd be tough. I'm kind of losing track of days right now. I was actually feeling that It's a Saturday for some reason. It's actually Sunday. Oh well. Meanwhile, we do have Itachi coming in. Yeah, this is from our spot up. Sculpted very tight angle. Should be careful here. It's going to continue to spray. Takes a magician and this bomb dropped. He's getting tracked from behind here. And the T's are pushing into the smoke. They don't have to push it through the smoke. Why are they pushing it through the smoke? They're all lining up and Sculpt's going to pick up a quad kill. And it's all going to be down to Hoax. With the Deagle. He's picked up. Should be able to pick up a FAMAS as well. No, he hasn't picked up the FAMAS. I don't know where it is. And it's going to be Code jumping into the smoke there. And Sculpt with a quad kill in the end there. They had the bomb. Yeah, I guess what they're trying to do. I mean, it was an eco round anyway. So they're just trying to take him down. But a great hold from Sculpt there. Picks up a 4k. And that's what happens when you don't have any armor. Yeah, for those of you new to Counter-Strike, you're like, oh, I don't need to buy armor. Yeah, I'm really good. But that's what happens in this. Just want to take a look at this again. Sculpt takes on Magician first. Nice use of the smoke. Forces him to push in through the smoke. Gets one. Does a ton of damage to the Spider and finishes it off with both of them lining up. And the Hoax, the only man to get a frag there. We do have the AWP on Troll. While the rest of the T's are on AKs. They have a number of smoke. Five smokes. They've got a number of flashbangs as well. And Killer spraying through the smoke. Doing a little bit of damage to Spider. And the T's taking it very, very slow. And they Troll boosted on top of the boxes, but will not be able to spot anyone out. We do have a boost coming up over a tree for Redefine. We have Phosphines. And Sculp. Oh, he's going to spot the man out. It's going to be Troll taking him down. Magician with a quick kill onto Phosphine and Itachi as well. He's doing a ton of damage. Our Killer has got to get a lot of kills here, but no, he's doing a lot of damage, but not able to get any single kill. Code, meanwhile, left alone here in 1v5. How did that happen? Is he going to find one? No, he wants Spider running and gunning, and that's going to be a flawless round coming out from from Anonymous. Not losing a single man as well, and especially a Magician doing huge work there with his two kills in the beginning. And now, Redefine Gaming, they will have to go on their own eco. The money getting reset. So both the teams just resetting the other team. And Anonymous though. 6-5. It is the 12th round here. So that's a very important round to win. This late here. Oh! Troll misses a pretty much an easy shot. Won't miss it again though. His Code is going to get taken down. He's shutting down mid from any potential aggression from the CTs. And his CTs with pretty light buy. Spider's gonna find Phosphines. Troll should be careful here. Rattles off a shot. He's taking a lot of damage with the man who's duking it out with him. And Troll is gonna, however, get the kill. Killer, meantime, with a Deagle, two quick kills. Is he gonna get more? No, one Magician is gonna take him down, leaving it all down on Itachi, who might be able to get the kill here on a Spider. Yes, he does, and he knows the C4 is in the B bomb site, where there's a man waiting for him. The bomb has been planted. And it's going to be now Magician and Troll. Troll's on a 13 points of health, so he should be careful here. Itachi hasn't spotted out. Troll gets taken down. And I don't know why he's fighting here. Itachi is going to get the kill. What was that? What was that, Magician? And Troll, I don't know what they were doing. It was a 2v1, and they were just out in the open, playing a little more safely there, and my word. That was such sloppy play there from Anonymous. They had the round, and Itachi just clutches it out in a 1v3. Nonetheless, he just had a P250, picks up the guy over a drop, kicks the AK, and wins the round. And that's going to be 6-6. The scores are tied. That's Redefine. They throw themselves a lifeline. Thanks especially to Anonymous. Kind of sloppy play here. Phosphine doing a lot of damage on a Troll. It's now 12 points of felt, and Troll does reply back a little bit with a parting shot of his own. And Phosphine's down to 41. Not as bad as Troll. This is going to be a very crucial round. Because looking at the money of both the teams, whichever team wins loses this round will be forced to go for an eco. And that's going to give the other team two rounds. So whichever team wins this particular round is going to get up to 8 rounds. Unless they play like idiots and throw it away to an anti-eco, but let's see. killer, just holding the angle over in platform, but he's not going to find anyone. The rest of the T's are making all their way to gathering up to go for this mid play here. And they're coming into the A bomb site as it looks like our observer has passed away. Hoax gonna get code. There we go. Observer's back. But it's taking a lot of damage. Force Fiends could get this kill here on Troll. He's gonna find one. Scorp with a great kill on the Magician. But a nice refrag coming up from Spider on the Force Fiend. And Scorp's trying to stay alive. But Hoax coming in from Van. He's gonna get the kill here. And Killer with the AWP peeking up. But two guys waiting for him. Itachi finds one. Gonna get another one. Is a question. Yes, he does. It's a 1v1 right now. And both of them are so very low in health. 8 points of health on Itachi versus 6 for Emeya. Emeya might be looking the wrong way here. Looking up, left, right, down, center. And Itachi coming in from behind. Spots the man out. One tap at the back at the base of the skull. Emeya gets taken on. Itachi once again, the hero for Redefine Gaming, clutches it out in another 1v3. They better buy this guy a beer after this game. He saved them from two rounds already. 7-6 Anonymous. Their money's broken. They will be going for Nico. So very close indeed. And just smart play. Using his brains, not panicking whatsoever. Emeya really caught her looking the wrong way there. 7-6, it's going to be an eco round coming up from Anonymous. Just tech nines all across the board. And Scorp with the deagle is going to fight one, gets a second kill as well. And he's the only guy with no rifles, and he's just taking the fight. Picks up two. Fine is going to take him down by Hoax and Magician, but it's conveyed information to the rest of his teams that, hey, guess what? They're coming over to the A-bomb site, and all they have to pick up from Sculpt is going to be the Deagle. Itachi is going to find one. Code with the M4, but Hoax with the Deagle is going to catch out Code through the flames, and now Force Fiends takes on Emeya, and that's going to be the last man left alive. Hoax alone with the Deagle. He could get one. Finally finds Force Fiend, but it's going to come up with something magical. Killer, however, is not going to miss that shot, and Hoax is going to get taken down. 8-6, and Anonymous will be going for their final buy here in the last round. Let's see if they're going to make it at least 8-7, which should be a pretty decent scoreline, or if Redefine can make it 9-6 on their side pick. And bear in mind, I really do feel Cobblestone is a much more T-sided map. So Redefine, they make it 9, definitely in their advantage. But then again, it's Counter-Strike, and it's Indian Counter-Strike especially, so anything can happen. It just defy all logic possible. Itachi, only gonna need a drop, using that smoke to cover himself. They have an AWP on Hoax as well. You usually do see Troll playing with a big green gun. A spider. Holding near drop, playing the low crow, probably trying to go for a late drop down into that area once the rest of his teams will execute into the B bomb site. Flashbang's gonna come in from Force Fiend. He's gonna use it to peek out, not gonna spot anyone, however. Hoax still holding over a platform with the AWP, waiting for a CT to get a little bit too aggressive, as two guys now preparing to go for this drop execute. But the looks of it, nope, they're still a little undecided. Scorp is pushing very deep, too aggressive indeed. He's gonna get taken down by Scorp, and now the flashbang is gonna come in. Itachi's gonna find Spider, and Force Fiends shifting it up a little bit. He can be the main man here. The flash not gonna blind him though. He's gonna find one. Can he get the second? Just continue to spray. Magician somewhat surviving. And now the P90 comes into place. Code's going to take down Emeya. It's all down now to Magician and Hoax. Magician's going to do some crazy magic. As all down to Hoax now. As Magician's going to get taken down. Hoax going to find one. He's going to get a second kill. No, he's not. Going to go for a fast scope. But the bomb is dropped as well. This is going to be very hard indeed. And Itachi is going to take him down with a 5-7 through the box. 9-6 for Redefine Gaming. So very back and forth game so far. But Redefine going to come out on top here in their first half. Anonymous on a CD site right now. Let's see what they're gonna bring forth for us. And can get Sculp here with a perfect flash. Picks up a double kill there. That was such a risky play, but it worked out for him. I mean, he just had the deagle, so going aggressive, and they knew that the T's would be in a very light bio, pretty much a full eco. And it's a smart play indeed. Redefine, though, they have four guys with armor and the Glock, Sculpt with the smoke and a couple of flashes. That's very crucial, especially on Cobblestone, which is why I was very surprised when Anonymous on their T side, they had nothing. They just went in dry and got a little lucky. That first fiend's coming in aggressively. There, four guys in the B bomb side. Amir's gonna find one. And it's a stack from the CTs here. As Itachi's gonna find one, Frost Fiend finds another kill as well. Now Troll's gotta go big here, and he's gonna find a kill on his Sculpt, and he's all alone now in a 1v3. Can still do something, but the bomb has now been planted, and the kit is not with him. It has been dropped. I'm gonna spot a guy at the edge of the statue there, and Redefine going for aggressive double peeks, and he's gonna find Killer. Don't need to go for the peeks. They don't need to go for the peeks. They have this round in the bag. They don't need to go for any fights here, and instead they're going to give it to him. Troll is going to get another kill, and this is just horrendous. Why would you do that? Why would you go for the peaks? I don't understand. Why would you do that, Redefine? Why do you give me cancer? That was horrendous. That was absolutely horrendous. 1v3. He had no kit either, and he just had to set up a crossbar, but nope, you want to go for those glory kills, man. I don't even know. I don't really blame Itachi. He was playing it smart and safe, but Force Fiends, another guy who peeked out, why? Not taking anything away from Troll, he played that perfectly. That was very well played indeed. But atrocious, absolutely atrocious post-plant play coming out from Redefine. And if that's how you're gonna like do it, man, I mean, that's what loses you games. That's a C4 bug, I guess. I've been a little confused, actually. I actually thought the C4 was planted a couple of rounds when it wasn't. So the C4 bug, I think it's a GoTV bug. Might need to restart or reconnect to the GoTV in order to get that fixed, but that's all right. Magician with the MP7 failing that initial jump and is looking for more, spraying through the smoke, doing some damage. And Hoax is actually taking a ton of damage as well. 16 points of health is all he has remaining against those Tech 9 and armors. And they got four smokes on the T's. They are not letting this go. They're going to just push in. But Hoax, just going for the drive-bys here, doing a lot of damage as well. Code and Force Fiends are pretty low. And I might be able to get a kill on the Itachi. Itachi completely blinded. And Spider's going to find one more before Sphinx is going to take down Hoax. Sphinx is very low, though, internally bleeding. He's going to get taken down by Spider with MP7. He has to reload here. But look at Magician coming in from the side with the flank. He's going to find one. Magician just hungry for more. And he should be able to catch out the last man. But nope, Sculpt stays alive. Still, with a Tech 9. He has to be reloading now in Troll. But the M4 comes and takes him down. And in the end, pretty comfortable round for Anonymous, losing just a couple of SMGs. And Redefine will be forced to go for a full eco here. Anonymous with a great opportunity to tie things up at 9-9. And Redefine, man, that pistol round's gonna haunt them. I actually hope it haunts them later. Like, you know, when the game is really tight. I'm not favoring any team, but if they do lose this game to 16-14 or something, I want them to go back to this demo or, you know, have a talk later and say, hey, yeah, this is how we lost this game. Meanwhile, a very fast A play coming out from the T. Sculpt is going to take down Amaya. And there's an M4 being picked off as well. And Code with a Glock. Tapping away. Magician is going to get Sculpt. He doesn't know there's a guy right underneath him as a bomb is going to get planted. So already a very good round here. And he dies to a Glock. Vosfine's going to find another kill, but it's so low here. Magician can't clutch this out for his team, though. He's got no kit. Vosfine flirting with danger. He might catch out the guy here, and it's gone before Sphinx taken. A Magician able to reload in time. In the 28 points of health, it's all he had remaining against pretty much a full eco round from Redefine. They got the bomb down as well, so a pretty good eco round here. Redefine Gaming will be able to go for a very much more comfortable buy going into their first rifle round here. But the scores are tied now, 9-9. And Magician, he almost reloaded, but then actually, yeah, he quick swapped back. But a valiant effort from Force Fiends there. Now is a trial for Anonymous. Can they hold off against Redefine Gaming and their full buy? We have the op on Killer, 4 AKs, a multitude of utilities. Smoke, small, tall flashes, and nades. Question is, how effectively are they going to use them? Once again, it's gonna be Magician playing over from the stairs, the new B platform stairs. And the smoke gonna dissipate, but gonna be re-smoked off by his teammate. Well, redefine it, taking it very slow. They have Code lurking over near mid, while the rest of the T is just spamming through the smoke, waiting for the smoke to dissipate before they can make their play here. Still a minute on the clock, and Sculpt with a nice peek into drop zone is going to find two men. Spider anime has been taken down. They still have two guys inside the side. There's going to be Magician and Hoax. Will they be checking that? I don't know why they don't check the stairs anymore. Hoax going to find a kill, making now 3v3. Make that a 2v3. Magician is a single handless shutting down this B platform. Picks up a triple kill. Last man left alive is going to be Code. And Magician is looking for more. He doesn't have to. Hoax is going to take him down. And from a 3v5, they just shut it down. Didn't lose a single man as well. And that was a little surprising from Redefine. They got two kills in drop zone. I get it. But most guys play four guys over in underpass and B. So even though they know they got two guys in underpass, they should have known. They should have been, at the very least, you know, most probably two more guys in the B bombs. That's a very careless play coming out from them. No one checking that stairs or no one marking that B platform stairs. And Magician just wreaking havoc from their position. And Redefine Gaming will be going for an interesting buy here. Oh, I don't get this buy. Sculpt with a full AK buy. Two guys, AK armor buy. He's down to zero. Like, he has no money remaining. The rest of them with Tech 9 armor, a couple of flashbangs, a couple of smoke, and a mix as well. And Code and Itachi still have $2,500, $2,000. And Phosphine and Killer on $1,000. So I don't get this. I don't know why they're wrecking the economy like this, because the next round is going to be the max money bonus and they will be getting $3,400. So I guess that makes sense. But except for Sculpt, he could have gone with Tech 9 armor as well. And you know, cheeky peek from Magician there. Troll finds Sculpt. It gets immediately taken down. Troll's going to swap his AK for that AWP. Magician is just playing with fire here. Ballsy play from him. He's gonna get taken down. Sculpt with his double kill off the round. He has an AWP as well. Rattling off a couple of shots through the smoke. As now the man advantage with the CTs. Sculpt is looking the right way. He hears the... I think he almost sees a muzzle flash from the gun. But the CT not gonna peek out there. Still playing it slow. As the rest of the T's are slowly falling back to the B bomb set, or are they? Nope, they're just gonna smoke it off. They're gonna smoke off B, go for the fake there, because they know Sculpt has control of this this part of the A bomb site. And that's a very smart play indeed, unless they are gonna fall back. Or no, they're gonna go to drop zone, and they're gonna get slaughtered by Spider there. And what is this? What? Why would it do that? Why would they go to the drop zone when they had no information there? I just don't understand this thought process coming out from Redefine. They had Sculpt getting control of long, and they had a man advantage. They could have easily smoked off the doors and gone for the A site, right? I mean, they could have. And instead, they went for a B smoke fake, which is pretty fine as well. They could have smoked off B, drawn off at least one or two CTs, you know, to make force them to rotate over the B bomb site. But they could have still gone for the A play. Instead, they dropped into drop zone with the C4, mind you, when they knew that the CTs should be playing around that area, because they were right behind the door. So that's a stupid play from Redefine. They should have definitely gone for A, or for that matter, they could have tried going for B as well. I mean, but when they had the man advantage, and they had control of that angle, but Scope was holding with the AWP. I just don't get it. They could have faked A, gone B. Could have faked B, gone A. Either one is a pretty, you know, is a pretty good play. But instead, they're just going to be just went to drop, and they just got slaughtered by Spider with a triple kill. Scope's going to find the first kill, but it hoax with a very fast kill onto Itachi. He's trying to rotate over to the truck here, but he's going to get caught out by Scope. I get what he's trying to do, trying to go in the stairs and change up his position, but that takes a while to run there. It's a marathon to run. And he really didn't have the time, didn't have a utility as well. He could have thrown a flashbang at the very least. Sculpt's gonna find one kill. Magician with a quick refrag, but Code is there to immediately take him down. Leaving down now to Troll, who hasn't spotted out here, and is getting taken down by Sculp with the quad kill of the round. Sculp has just been a monster this entire game for his team. He's on 20 frags, Itachi on 20 as well. And for Anonymous, Hoax on 21, and Spider on 19, Magician on 18, and Troll on 17. Ameya having a very rough game, but he's on just 7 kills as we are now in the 22nd round. And it's going to be a very iffy buy coming out. Very iffy buy. I don't know, man. I don't even understand these buys. Just for Mosses. And Itachi's going to hit on Hoax. Their smart shot through the smoke. Sculp's going to find Magician. And this force buy is just falling apart. Not exactly force buy. More of a half-arsed buy, I'd say. They didn't have armor, they didn't have the rifles, they had the FAMASs, but not a very strong buy. Didn't have enough utility as well, not even Molotovs or, nades or whatnot. And they're gonna get picked apart by the AKs of Redefine. And Redefine Gaming, with a man advantage, they can't afford to throw this away. We're gonna check the corner here. Troll's gonna find one, gets a second kill as well, switch over to AK, finally Killer's gonna take him down. He's gonna leave it at 2v3. And Spider falls to Sculp, and meanwhile Code is going to catch out Ameya, and that is going to be 11-11. The scores are tied. This game is kind of topsy-turvy. Anonymous now will be forced to go for a full eco, and Redefine should know this. I wouldn't be surprised to see an SMG coming out in Force Fiends. Maybe a MAC-10 on a fact-finding mission just rushing in. Instead, going to go for the AK here. And Troll, he's been doing whatever he can. Oh, they're just running in. Sculp knows this. He hears him out. Sprays on a man. And they know this. They know it's a push from the CTs. And Force Fiend just holding the back lines. He's going to find one more. Sculp's going to find Troll. And Magician and Hoax are now caught in between a rock and a very, very hard place indeed. Last man left alive is going to be Hoax. And Sculp should be able to get his third kill here. He does. A little scary in the end. The quad kill, in fact. Sculp racking up the eco frags. 12-11, Redefine Gaming in the lead once more. Anonymous with their buy. This has just been just all over the place. Sculp's gonna find Ameya meantime. So, like I said, Ameya's having a very rough time. Troll being a little too aggressive there. Killer's gonna take him down. Nice flashbang coming out here, and Sculp is gonna get another one. And this guy is just like bleeding the CTs. Hoax is down 13 points of health. Bomb's not down yet though. They know both the CTs are in the B bomb site. The bomb is still in T spawn. What is this? Hoax is gonna find Itachi. Hoax finds Code as well, and it's all on the Killer right now. What was that? What was that? When you knew both the CTs were there in the B bomb site, you just needed to get the C4 all the way to the A bomb site. You just keep on T over there, play distraction, and what was that? I don't get it. Hoax with a great triple kill, but Redefine sloppy play again, man. I think they really hate themselves. So many rounds where they manage to snatch victory from the warm, they managed to snatch defeat, I'm sorry, from the warm embrace of victory. And, they know it's an A plant. Killer can clutches out. Molotov over near the balcony is going to prevent any early push from the CTs. They have a kit on Hoax though. It's a nice flashbang coming out from CTs. And Killer, does he know? Spots out Hoax. 1v1. Magician and Killer. Hoax has done his job. He's got a triple kill, and it's going to be Killer. Clutches out for his team, and what should have been a very comfortable round instead. And Killer with a little bit of BM there in the end. Love it. Love it. Just goes for the crotch grind into the body of his fallen teammate there. You gotta love that sort of game. And now Redefine against Anonymous, who are an eco. They should not be throwing this away. Amir is going to find Skull. Meanwhile, Skull trying to go for the drop play once more. And they have, once again, four T's waiting for them. Nade's going to do a ton of damage. Magician gets caught out. Itachi picks up the double kill. Spider still holding that angle. Down 30 points of health. No, and Hoax gets taken down. Spider falls as well. And they are just getting wrecked by the T's on their eco round. As Redefine will make it 14 rounds to 11 against Anonymous. Anonymous now. Now the buy is the do or die buy. They have lost. But this round, it's going to be the fifth round they've lost in a row here. Troll has picked up the AK. Might be able to salvage it. That's all they can do right now. They're looking for more. Oh, spraying through the door. Might just get the kill though. And he will, but finally is going to get taken out of Force Fiends. So, eking out a little bit of economic damage to the T's, but I think they should be pretty comfortable redefining on in a very healthy money situation at the moment. And for Anonymous, they will be able to buy very comfortably. Max money bonus coming into effect, and along with the previous eco round, they will be able to afford whatever they want. But the question is, dual up setup coming out as well, Hoax and Troll both wielding the big green. The question right now is, if they lose this round, that's pretty much going to be it. They won't have, they'll still have max money bonus, but it's going to be tough. It's going to be very tough indeed. So 14 to 11. And Redefine Gaming, just a couple of rounds closer to knocking out Anonymous from the ESL India Premiership Starter Cup. Skull has been the player to watch this entire game here. Troll rounds off a shot though. He's getting taken down, not able to get a single kill or even do any damage. And he's going to get taken by Killer, but Hoax with his AWP is going to get on Killer. And Emeya with a nice spread out on the court, but he's going to get traded almost immediately before Spies looks for more, picks up the top of kill. Itachi's going to find Magician. It's all down to Spider now in a 1v3. This is not going to be easy. He has a guy flanking in from behind as well. And it's going to be Scope looking for the hunt here. And Spider with a fast shot on the Scope. He's looking for more. They don't have to go for the peaks here. They don't have to peek. They don't have to peek. Please don't peek. Flashbang comes in. Spider. What's he doing? I think they know where he is. Maybe not. Scope's in. I don't know if Force Fiends heard him there. Scope goes for the fast scope there. Want to miss it, but Itachi will take him down in the end. Looking once again a little hairy for Redefine. They just love giving heart attacks to their, to themselves, anyone watching this game. But 15 to 11, game point, match point, map point for Redefine Gaming. Anonymous will be able to scrap together enough money for a few for Masters, an M4, one Deagle and Hoax, but that's all they have. It's the final Hail Mary buy. They got to make something happen here. They try digressing, they keep getting taken out by Redefine, they try playing passively, they get swamped over. What can they do at this juncture is a question. Dual Ops or Redefine? Not a big fan of Dual Ops on the T side, especially in a map like Cobblestone, but let's see what they're going to be able to pull off. I do have Troll playing a very tight angle, should be able to get a kill on Force Fiends. Yes he does, but Sculp is there to go for the immediate trade. Sculp. That's going to actually draw the rotation. Now there's one guy in the A bomb site and one guy over near connected. It's one guy in drop and one guy in the B bomb site. The CD defense has been stretched very, very thin, especially with that kill. Now they have two guys in the A bomb site and they have only Sculp, while the remaining three members of the team. Sculp's going to catch out Emeya here. That's so sloppy. Emeya watching your slope while... And this could be huge. It's just one guy in the B bomb site. It's going to be Magician. He's going to find the one kill. And he's going to have to hold fort against his two T's here. They still haven't made your way inside the site, and Sculp is just a beast in the A bomb site. Takes out Hoax as well, and now Magician wondering what he should do. He gets taken down as well. It's all on the Spider. He's going to get the one kill, but it's a 1v2, and he's getting flanked by Sculp as well. The bomb's not down yet, still with 35 seconds on the clock. Spider, he has a chance to still keep his team in this game. Bomb finally still not planted, still dropped on top of platform. Flashbang comes in, not going to blind him though. Sculp gets taken down, and Spider just might be able to clutch it out here. Itachi picks up the bomb now. Drops it. He's not going to be spotted out, but now he knows where he is. And it's going to be Spider. Clutches the round 1v3. And keep his team's hopes and dreams alive. And Redefine Gaming. That play from Sculp when he flashed into Underpass. The room outside. Not Underpass, I'm sorry. He flashed into... the room right outside drop zone, and went in for that. I don't know why he did that. They should have known the CT would be there. They know they knew the CT was there. They knew Spider was there. He could have just gone over to the B bomb site and enabled his teammate to plant the bomb. And Maya is going to win this duel this time with Scope. Scope has been winning that duel so many times, but this time it's not going to work out for him as Maya is going to take him down. But bear in mind, the buy is still very iffy from Anonymous because they just had one guy staying alive in the end there. So the money is not that great yet. Phosphine duking it out over on the pass. Code's going to find Hoax. And Phosphine with a flashbang trying to create as much of a distraction as he can, but Magician is going to find a kill under Code with a FAMAS of his. He's going to go for the duel, picks up the second kill as well as Killer is going to find Troll. And Phosphine getting sprayed from behind. He is getting sandwiched here. Reloads in time, makes his way out. And Anonymous and Phosphine are going to pass each other, but it's still a guy right beyond in the stairs area of B Plateau, and he is going to stay alive as Amaze is going to take that force fiends, leaving it down to Killer with the AWP against three CTs, 15-12. The game is not done yet. Killer making haste, pushing in towards long. This is not easy, though. This is definitely not easy. He's going to announce his presence with that smoke. We'll at least get the bomb down. Problem is, the buy is not going to be easy, and he's playing aggressively. I like this play from him. But Magician comes in with a flank from Balcony, takes on Killer before he gets a chance to rattle off a shot. So 15-13, Anonymous are still very much in this game, because this is going to force... this is going to force Redefine to go for... Oh, this is tough, man. This is tough. They should eco. They should eco. Nope, they're gonna buy out. This could bite them in the butt. And I'll tell you why. $1,513 on Code and on Force Fiends and Code respectively, while the rest of the team are at $0, $400, and $600. So if they lose this round without getting the bomb down, they're just gonna be getting $2,400 in bonus money, right? So $2,400 means that Force Fiends and Code can still buy AKs with armor and maybe a couple of smokes. The rest of the team, though, they're just going to have about $3,000, which is not enough. They might be able to afford it a little, maybe Tech Nines, but it's going to be a half-assed buy. So this is a very risky buy for Redefine Gaming. I'm not a very big fan of this. And they're going to lose a man early on as well. Magician going to take down Killer. And Troll is, meanwhile, alone in the A-bomb site here. He should be calling for backup real quickly. Rotation coming in from one of his teammates. And he's going to drop down. Is he going to get the kill? No, he won't. Force Fiends is going to take him down. As Amir is going to find one. Team kill comes in from Spider. Spider gets taken down. What is this? Hoax finds a man, though. It's our 2v2. And a bomb has been planted. Itachi and Force Fiends. They can just close it out right now. Force Fiends finds Hoax. Magician finds Force Fiends. It's all down Itachi now. He knows exactly where Magician is. It looks away the wrong direction. Magician comes out though. And it's going to be Itachi spraying here. And Magician just misses the shot of Peter. He comes out and he wins the clutch. And he wins the clutch 15-14. Anonymous, how are they doing this? How are they still in this game? They did get the bomb down. They did get the bomb down. So that's a little bit more money. But look at the money right now for Redefine. Like I said, Phosphine and Code can buy up. The rest of them, yeah, it's not very comfortable. It's not very comfortable. Killer and Itachi have less than $3,600. $3,600 and $3,500 for Itachi and for Killer. So that's not great. They can't buy an AK and armor. And the CTs, they have M4s, right? So if the CTs had all of them had AKs, then all right, you know, you can sacrifice the armor to go for a Kevlar buy. But this is risky here. So Itachi going to go for the AK Kevlar. He's just going to hope that the CTs don't land a headshot with an M4 with the first bullet. So four AKs. All right, four AKs, three smokes, one Molotov, and four flashbangs. They got the nades as well. I would rather go for Molotovs than nades, to be very honest, on the T side. We have a pause coming in, and pause coming in as well as Redefine Gaming deciding what are they going to do here. The over-peaking from Redefine on their post-plant is something they need to address immediately. They're not bad at all. They're not a bad team at all. Playing pretty well. But the thing is, there's so many rounds that have given up. Just over-peaking, just being too hungry. for more when, you know, they could have just played the crossfires. Don't peek. Don't over peek. You don't need to. You don't need to be a hero. As Hoax already down 29 points of health. And Killer just on top of the box. Right behind the box on top of Hoax. I don't think Hoax knows this. This is just very smart play indeed. He's not going to check behind him though. And Killer, oh, Force Fade just opens it up. Hoax staying left for so long, but he baited his teammates. He's going to get taken down in the end by Sculpt. And it's all down to Troll in a 1v4. And this should be impossible. This should be impossible indeed. Troll is going to find one. He can't win this. Redefine game, he can't. They can't throw this. I mean, this is the shot onto Sculpt, and it's going to be Sculpt fittingly ending the game 16-14. That was a close game indeed. And we have, there we have, look at the stats at 34 kills to Sculpt. He was the player to watch. He single-handedly kept Redefine Gaming in the game here. And Magician, Hoax, and Troll, I mean, taking nothing away from these guys, except for Emeya, who had a very rough game. The rest of Anonymous really did show up. They really played their hearts out. Redefine Gaming looked the superior team. They looked much more stronger than Anonymous, but the thing was, they made so many stupid mistakes, which gave Anonymous the window of opportunity to get back into the game. But in the end, Redefine Gaming will be the victorious team, 16-14, and Jesus, that was a tight game indeed. That was a very tight game. So don't go anywhere. We'll be going live with the map, with game number two, which is going to be Negative Evolution facing off against JLT, which will be coming right up. And you, of course, are watching ESL India Premiership. My name is Blay, and don't go anywhere. We'll be back with game number two of the evening in the next couple of minutes.